Welcome back guys, I'm Vidya and today I'm going to share with you how I have altered a baby talcum powder bottle using decoupage technique. But before moving on to the tutorial, consider subscribing to my channel guys. So I've taken just a normal Johnson's baby powder bottle and I'm removing the label on top of it. It is pretty easy to remove that label. I'm going to leave the lid on because it will be easier for me to hold the bottle when I'll be painting it. Now for painting this bottle, I'm going to use white gesso, but you can use normal white acrylic color as well. I'm using a regular dishwashing sponge to paint this bottle, not using any fancy tools to paint this bottle. You can also use a brush to paint it, but I don't like brush strokes on the bottle, so I'm going to use a sponge. Now to speed up the drying process, I'm going to use a heat gun. But if you don't have a heat gun, you can just leave this bottle on the countertop to dry it completely before you apply the second coat of the gesso or the acrylic color. Now I'm going for a second coat of the gesso. I'm going to make sure that I'm applying an even coat of this second layer and I'm again going to dry it using my heat gun. Now I have these gorgeous tissues which has rose print on it. They are 2-ply tissues. That means that every single tissue is made of 2 layers of tissues and I'm going to separate both of those layers. In any craft store, you might be able to find tissues which are 3-ply. That means they will have 3 layers of tissues. So you will have to separate the other 2 layers from the printed tissue sheet. Now once I have this thin layer of printed tissue sheet, I'm going to fuzzy cut the roses from this tissue. As the working surface area of our bottle is very small, I'm going to cut these flowers individually so that I can have a layout and I can work on it by overlapping them. While cutting the design from this tissue, make sure that you are very carefully cutting it because the layer of this tissue is very thin, it is a possibility that the design might get ripped off. Now I'm going to start by cutting this beautiful big pink rose. It is so beautiful and gorgeous. I'm carefully cutting it along the lines. Similarly, I have cut the other roses individually. I might just add a few buds here and there while cutting these roses. I'm fine to leave that little white border while cutting these roses. As the base of our bottle is also white, it will just merge into it. Now, once I have fuzzy cut all the big roses, I'm also going to cut smaller roses so that those small roses can be used as fillers by laying out this design on that bottle. Now we have fuzzy cut all the roses and here comes the fun part. Now we are going to start laying out these roses on the bottle. I'm going to apply a thin layer of my homemade Mod Podge and I'm going to then stick these flowers in such a way that they might overlap here and there. You can also use store-bought Mod Podge for this decoupage technique. If you want to know how I made this homemade Mod Podge, then leave your request in the comment section and I'll make a video on it. Now I'm going to carefully lay out this big pink rose. I'm going to smoothen it out using my finger. Make sure that there are no creases and wrinkles when you stick this tissue paper on the bottle. You can smoothen out any creases using your finger or a flat brush. Now I'm going to stick another rose and I'm going to try to overlap it with the first one. Again, I'm making sure that there are no creases and wrinkles, and if there are any, I'm going to smoothen it out using my finger. And similarly, I've stuck all the other roses so that they little bit overlap here and there, and a beautiful cluster of the roses are formed on our bottle. I'm going to lay out these roses on one side of the bottle so that it is easier to seal them. And then I'm going to work around on the other side of the bottle. Now after laying out all those big roses, if you feel that there are empty spaces between the roses, then you can fill up those empty spaces using some smaller buds or even the smaller roses. Once all these roses are stuck on one side, I'm now going to start applying a thin layer of Mod Podge on those tissue paper roses. Now while applying this thin layer of Mod Podge, make sure that you are moving from center of the design to the outside of the design. So you are moving out of the design and not inwards of the design. Moving the brush from inside to outside will ensure that all the creases and the wrinkles are flattening out automatically, and it will also ensure that there is no curling up at the border of the tissue. When applying this Mod Podge on the tissue paper design, it is important that you use a flat brush. A flat brush not only helps in flattening out the creases and the wrinkles, but it also seals the design well, and it doesn't leave any lump or stroke of the Mod Podge. Now it's time to lay out those flowers at the back of the bottle. I'm using the same technique. So I have applied a thin layer of Mod Podge on which I'm going to stick those tissue paper flowers. I'm going to overlap them on other flowers so that it looks like a cluster of the flowers. And again, I'm going to flatten them out using finger. And the final step is to apply a thin layer of Mod Podge on those roses so that all the design is then sealed. I'm going to leave a link of all the supplies I have used so you can buy them online. And this decoupage technique is so versatile. You can use it on metal, wood, plastic, even glass. Decoupage is one of the easiest methods to upcycle anything that is lying around your home. So any waste bottle, containers, boxes, you name it, and you can alter it. Now I'm again using my heat gun to dry this bottle. And finally, I'm going to seal all of this together using a spray varnish. I'm not going to show this step on the video as I'm going to spray it in a well-ventilated area. I have then removed the lid of this bottle, and I'm now going to cover the top part of this bottle. I'm going to use a woolen pink yarn to cover this. I'm using a glue gun to stick this. And our decoupage baby talcum powder bottle is ready to be used as a vase. And I also altered an old body wash and shampoo bottle, which I then used as a hand wash bottle. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and also leave a comment. I would love to read your comments. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing to my channel so you won't miss out on any of my future videos. I'll see you next time. Bye.